At a tenth of the cost of conventional missile defense systems, this laser weapon can destroy targets, including mortars, drones, and rockets. Israel built the Iron Beam as part of an experimental endeavor. It might be deployed in conjunction with the Iron Dome, one of the world's most sophisticated air defense systems that fires a rocket. Although Israel claimed that the Iron Beam might improve defense against threats against Iran supporters in Gaza and Lebanon, several defense experts claim that the technology has several drawbacks, notably its limited range. Israel and the US are in discussions about collaborating on the technology to improve the system. In today's video, we reveal details about the Iron Beam system, how it functions, and why some military analysts believe that the American experience could improve it. Let's get started. One of the most recent and cutting-edge military innovations, Iron Beam, also known as Light Shield, employs a directed energy beam to guard against aerial strikes. It can successfully neutralize a variety of rocket, artillery, and mortar bomb types. In a certain sense, the Iron Dome, which can intercept projectiles and rockets, and does so at a wider range, competes with this new technology. However, at close range, the Iron Dome's effectiveness at intercepting decreases. The strongest aspect of the Iron Beam is its close interception range. It can efficiently take down a variety of targets, including all varieties of unmanned aerial vehicles, with an operational range of up to 4.25 miles, up to 12.5 miles afar. Some powerful Iron Beam modifications can fire laser beams at targets. In Iron Beam, a potent laser beam warms the target, causing damage to it in a matter of seconds, usually 3 to 6 seconds. In addition, it is less expensive to run than missile-based defensive systems, since a single shot costs about $3 to $3.50 instead of $49,999 to $150,001 for an interceptor missile firing. Israel is known for its technological advances in weapons, and is also one of the biggest exporters of arms in the world. Israel has been testing the laser-based defense system for a few years. Last year, they used it to shoot down a drone. At first, the plan was to put the system into service in 2024, but the military pushed for it to be done sooner. This was done because of worries that in a future war, the military wouldn't have enough interceptor missiles for other air defense systems, particularly the Iron Dome, to shoot down rockets, missiles, and drones that were coming at them. The Israeli-made laser system is meant to help defend against airborne missiles and some of the more expensive ways to stop rockets. The Iron Beam stops are quiet and can't be seen or heard. Iron Beam is part of a family of programs that are meant to stop everything from long-range missiles to short-range rockets. The ground-based laser design is not a substitute for Iron Dome or other air defense systems. It was made to go with Israel's Iron Dome system, which turned out to be expensive technology. According to rumors, Israel's defense system was supposed to include the Iron Beam in 2024. Israel hastened its preparations due to worries about the availability of missile interceptors for the Iron Dome and other defenses in times of conflict. In March of 2022, Benny Gantz, Israel's defense minister, gave the project millions of shekels in funding. According to Brigadier General Rez Yaniv Rotem, head of research and development for the Israeli Defense Ministry, the testing was done at challenging durations and periods. The trials appeared to have occurred in March 2022 at an unidentified location in the Negev Desert of Israel. The Iron Dome system has stopped incoming rockets 90% of the time, but it costs a lot to set up. It's thought that it will help them shoot down smaller projectiles. For a few hundred dollars, someone in Gaza can fire a rocket at Israel. Sadly, it costs tens of thousands of dollars for the Iron Dome to stop it. This is what the Iron Beam was built to change. Despite the lack of knowledge regarding its effectiveness, the government anticipates using the laser system on land, in the air, and at sea. Over the following few years, the laser devices will be mounted all along Israel's borders to protect the country from invasion. The new technique was made public to send warning messages to Iran and Palestine. This setup is claimed to perform better than all other current security measures and is more affordable, accurate, and user-friendly, since it runs on electricity only and costs less. The Israeli Defense Ministry said that Israel is one of the first places in the world to use powerful laser technology to make an air defense system that works. The Iron Beam, like weapons that use energy, is not a completely new idea, and neither is the way it works. There is a lengthy history of failure in the search for laser weapons. The Strategic Defense Initiative, popularly known as Star Wars, was established by President Ronald Reagan in 1983 to find a mechanism to fire down nuclear ballistic missiles using laser technology. That endeavor was given up in 1993 after spending over $200 billion with little to show for it. However, other programs continued the investigation. Israel and the United States attempted to create a test high-energy laser system with a less ambitious range in the late 1990s that was intended to kill missiles in flight. The Nautilus project was abandoned in 2005, in part due to the system's weight and subpar functionality. Defense publications say Israel has been planning a laser-based air defense network since the early 2000s. Israel wanted a replacement for the Iron Dome, but the dome was more important because laser technology was not a cost-effective tool then. In 2009, Rafael started making a defense system based on lasers. The first version of the Iron Beam was shown for the first time at the Singapore Air Show in 2014. At the time, Reuters said Israel planned to add the Iron Beam to its air defense systems in 2015. After 7 years, it has been looked at and seems close to being put in place. But other stories say that the Iron Beam has a short range, which makes it useless against long targets. On the other hand, the beam is thought to help stop short-range threats and defend against saturation strikes. People think the Iron Beam is very strong, and since there is a constant energy source, there is no worry of running out of ammunition. The problem with a laser weapon is that it doesn't work well in low visibility conditions, like when there are lots of clouds or other bad weather. So the ministry wants to put the technology on an airplane, which would help get around this problem by putting the system just above the clouds. However, professionals working on the system say it will be a few years before it can be used in the field, and experts warn that even then, it may not be able to protect Israel from a lot of rocket fire at first. That's all on Israel's new laser weapon Iron Beam explained. What do you think? Do you think Israel will become successful in this adventure? Do you think they can launch the system earlier than anticipated? Let us know your thoughts and ideas in the comment section below. If this video is insightful for you, then go on and like this video. Please kindly subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button for more of our updates.